Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Punishka Tutorials. In our previous video of rational numbers, we have seen that the decimal representation of a rational number can be either terminating or non-terminating. Today we will learn that without performing the actual long division method, how to determine if the rational number have a terminating decimal representation or a non-terminating decimal representation. So let's begin. Suppose we have a rational number p upon q, then p upon q is said to be terminating if p and q are co-prime numbers. If p and q do not have any common factors, then we say that p and q are co-prime numbers. And q is in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m. Okay? Q should be multiple of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, where n and m are non-negative integers. Let us take one example to understand the concept. Without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Suppose this is our rational number 13 upon 3125. First we will check whether 13 and 3125 are co-prime numbers or not. As we know that 13 and 3125 do not have any common factors, so 13 and 3125 are co-prime numbers. Now let's check whether the denominator is in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m. By division method, we will first find out all the prime factors of 3125. So 3125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. Okay, so this is equal to 5 raised to 5. Now denominator is in the form of 5 raised to 5, which can be written as 1 into 5 raised to 5, which is equal to 2 raised to 0 into 5 raised to 5. Any number raised to the power 0 is always 1. So to make it in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, the number 1 we will write as 2 raised to 0 in this case. So the denominator will be 5 raised to 5 is equal to 2 raised to 0 into 5 raised to 5. Now the denominator is expressed in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m, where n is equal to 0 and m is equal to 5. Both are non-negative numbers, both of them are positive integers. So 13 upon 3125 is a terminating decimal because both the numerator and denominator are co-prime numbers, and the denominator can be expressed in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, where n and m are positive integers. Let's take one more example. Suppose we have to check whether 64 upon 455 has a terminating decimal representation or a non-terminating decimal representation. First, we will check the numerator and denominator. Are they co-prime or not? 64 and 455 do not have any common factors. So 64 and 455 are co-prime. Now we will check the denominator. In the denominator we have 455. We will first do prime factorization of the denominator. We will get the value as 455 is equal to 5 into 7 into 13. Okay, now the denominator is equal to 5 into 7 into 13. Here we have factors other than 2 and 5, okay, which is not in the form of 2 raised to n and 5 raised to m. So the denominator cannot be expressed in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, and hence the rational number 64 upon 455 has a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Let's take few more example. Without actual division, determine which of the following rational numbers have a terminating decimal representation. We will take 21 upon 128. 21 upon 128, as we can see, both of them do not have any common factor. So 21 and 128 are co-prime numbers, and 128 can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 2 raised to the power 7. Okay, so 128 can be written as 2 raised to the power 7 into 5 raised to the power 0. It is expressed in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m. So the rational number 21 upon 128 has a terminating decimal representation. Our next example is 27 upon 125. 27 and 125 do not have any common factor. They are co-prime numbers. Now 125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5, which is equal to 5 raised to the power 3. 5 raised to the power 3 into 1. 1 we can write it as 2 raised to the power 0. 5 raised to 3 into 2 raised to the power 0. So the rational number 27 upon 125 has a terminating decimal representation, as both the numerator and denominator are co-prime numbers, and the denominator can be expressed as 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m, where n is equal to 0 and m is equal to 3. Next example, 39 upon 24. As we can see that 39 and 24 have some common factors, we will first bring this rational number in its standard form. The 24 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Both of them has 3 as a common factor. We will divide the numerator and the denominator with the number 3. 39 divided by 3 is 13. 24 divided by 3 is 8. Now in the denominator we have 8 and in the numerator we have 13. 13 and 8 are co-prime numbers. They do not have any common factor among them. And the denominator 8 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 2 raised to the power 3. So we can say that 8 can be expressed in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m, where 2 raised to n, n is equal to 3, 5 raised to m, m is equal to 0, n is equal to 3 and m is equal to 0, 8 is equal to 2 raised to 3 into 5 raised to 0. So the 35 upon 24 is a terminating decimal representation. Next is 17 upon 90. There are no common factors among 17 and 90. So 17 and 90 are co-prime numbers. Now when we write the prime factors of the denominator 90, it can be written as 90 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Here we see that the one of the factor, that is 3, is other than 2 and 5. For a rational number to be in terminating decimal representation form, both the numerator and denominator should be co-prime, and the denominator should be expressed in the form of 2 raised to n, 5 raised to m, where n and m are positive integers. Here we have one more factor other than 2 and 5, that is 3. So the rational number 17 upon 90 will not have a terminating decimal representation. So we can conclude that for a rational number to have a terminating decimal representation, the numerator and denominator should have no common factor. We have to first bring the rational number in a standard form, and then we have to compare the numerator and the denominator. Once there are no common factor between the numerator and the denominator, we have to perform the prime factorization of the denominator. In the prime factorization, we have to check if the denominator has factors other than 2 and 5. If the denominator has factor other than 2 and 5, the rational number can be expressed as non-terminating repeating decimal representation. But if the denominator can be expressed in the form of 2 raised to n into 5 raised to m, where n and m are positive integers, that time the rational number will have terminating decimal representation. Now let us see conversion of terminating decimals into rational numbers. Now we have to convert the decimal number 1.2 in the rational number standard form P upon Q. As we can see that the decimal point is placed between the digit 1 and 2, and there is only one digit after the decimal point. So we will write 1.2 as 1 to 12 upon 10, because only one digit is there after the decimal point. So we will write only 1 0 after the number 1. So this becomes 1.2 is equal to 12 upon 10, which is equal to 6 upon 5. The denominator is 1 followed by as many zeros as is the number of decimal places in the given number. Here we had only one digit after the decimal point, so we had placed only 1 0 in the denominator after the digit 1. So 1.2 is written in the form of 12 upon 10. Now we will bring this into the lowest terms, which is equal to 6 upon 5. Let's see some more examples. Suppose 0.4 is there. You have to convert this in the form of rational number P upon Q. Only one digit is there after the decimal point. So we will put only 1 0 after number, the digit 1, in the denominator. 0.4 becomes 4 upon 10, which is equal to 2 upon 5 in the standard form. Next example. 3.75. Here we can see that the decimal point is between 3 and 7, and after the decimal point we have two digits. So what we will do, in the denominator we will write 1 and we will write 2 0, because two digits are there after the decimal point. So we will write 2 zeros after the digit 1 in the denominator. So 3.75 will be written as 375 upon 100. Now after cancellation, after bringing the rational number in a standard form, 375 upon 100 can be written as 15 upon 4. Next example, 1.025. Here also the decimal point is between 1 and 0, and after the decimal point we have 3 digits. So we will put 1 in the denominator and we will place 3 zeros after the digit 1 in the denominator. So 1.025 will be written as 1025 upon 1000. 3 zeros, because 3 digits are there after the decimal point, which indicates that there should be 3 zeros after the digit 1 in the denominator. After bringing the rational number in the standard form, we will get 41 upon 40. Next is 56.875. Here also the decimal point is between 6 and 8, and after the decimal point we have 3 digits. So we will write 3 zeros after the digit 1 in the denominator. So this number will be written as 56875 upon 1000, which is equal to 455 upon 8 after bringing the rational number in its standard form. Suppose we have a negative decimal number, -2.56. In that case, we will simply write the minus sign and solve it as in the case of positive decimal number. We will write the minus sign here, and as we can see there are two digits after the decimal point. So in the denominator we will write 20 after the digit 1 in the denominator. After bringing the rational number in its standard form, we will get the value as -64 upon 25. Next is -0.25. Two digits are there after the decimal point, so we will put 2 zeros after the digit 1 in the denominator. Minus sign will be written as it is. So the number becomes minus 25 upon 100, which is equal to minus 1 upon 4. So to convert any decimal number in its standard form of rational number, that is p upon q, we have to check how many digits are there after the decimal point. If there is one digit after the decimal point in the denominator, we will write 1 and 10, because one digit is there after the decimal point, and we will write the numerator without the decimal point. We will cancel it. We will bring the rational number in its standard form. If after the decimal point we have two digits, then we will write 1, and after that we will put two zeros in the denominator. We will write 100. In the numerator, we will write the number without the decimal point, and in the denominator, we will write 100. We will cancel it and bring the rational number in its standard form. If there are three digits after the decimal point, then in the denominator, we will write 1 and 3 zeros. The number of digits after the decimal points will tell you how many zeros you have to place in the denominator after the digit 1, okay? And in the numerator, we will write the number as it is without the decimal point, and in the denominator we will write the number accordingly. If there are one digit after decimal point, we will write 10. If there are two digits after the decimal point, we will write 100. If there are three digits after the decimal point, then we will write 1000 in the denominator, and so on. Then we, after getting the rational number, we will bring it in the standard form. Here are some sums for practice so that you will understand the concept much better. If you have any doubt in the concept, please comment it in the comment section. If you like our video, please click on the like button, share it, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.